Hey everyone, John Flores from the BMW Riders Association. I'm here with special guest Demetrius Tournis. He's a member of the association, and his stories and photos of the 2020 GS Trophy appeared in the May-June issue of On the Level. Demetrius is also president of the GS Giants, one of the largest BMW clubs in the country, and focuses exclusively on adventure touring. And he's about to embark on a big trip of his own. Last I checked, it was about 9,000 miles, right? Approximately.
Around about there, yeah.
Okay. So, Demetrius, tell us three things about this trip that you are most excited about.
Hi, John. First of all, thank you for having me here. So there are a lot of things that I'm really excited about this trip, but the three top things is the lack of organizing the trip. It sounds a little bit weird, but the whole thing started back in August when I was actually ready to make the trip in the beginning. I had everything written down. I had all of my stops calculated to the mile, which day I'm going to be at what campground, what time I'm going to arrive there, what dinner I'm going to have, and what camp spot I'm going to take. Everything was written down. I had an exact mileage of all of my trip. People were waiting for me. And unfortunately, my dog had to go under surgery, and everything just fell apart. And that was a wake-up call for me that, you know, you can't always schedule, you can't always organize life the way that you want. Some things you just have to leave them completely open and free. So this is going to be the first motorcycle trip, if not the first trip in my life, that I'm just getting on my bike and leaving. And I'm just going. I'm going to go north, then I'm going to go east, then I'm going to go northeast, then I'm going to go south. I'm going to come back, and that's it. I have a few places that I want to be, and there is only one place that I want to be in a specific date because I have an event that it's already scheduled, and everything else is just open.
Demetrius, I'm going to pop it on the screen, but Demetrius sent me a map, and you'll see it's probably the most detailed travel map you'll ever see, but it'll pop up right here. All right, what's the next thing?
The next thing is all the people that I'm going to meet. When I first posted that I'm going on a 9,000, 10,000 mile trip, people that I have met or I have not met on social media contacted me out of nowhere, and they just offered their houses. They opened up their houses so I can go there and spend some time, you know, spend the night, socialize, talk to them, and it's just amazing. This is what the motorcycle community is supposed to be, and I am so glad to see that in a group like the BMW Riders Associations or the GS Giants, that people are just out of nowhere coming together to help other riders because they know that they would get the same treatment when it's their time, and I'm really looking forward for that.
Oh, that's awesome. Very, very cool. You're right about the community. It's a very, very tight community. Are you bringing camping gear or anything like that? Or
Yes. I'm bringing camping gear. My plan is to do a 4-to-1 ratio. So every fourth day, I'm going to be staying in a motel just to probably do laundry or just stretch my bones and, you know, have a look at the bike and, you know, under better light and all of that, just make sure that everything is okay. But mostly it's going to be camping, dry camping for the most part. Do have a tent, I have a hammock, whatever is possible. I've slept on the ground, on a bench. It doesn't matter, whatever. It's just really not organized.
<That's>
so
great.
Whatever I find in front of me.
I've done some hammock camping, and it's hard out west when you only have one tree around. But it can be done.
True.
It can be done. But you have a tent too, so that's good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what's your third thing that you wanted that you're really really excited about?
So the third thing is the last part of my trip. If you look at the detailed map, at some point it says training. So I'm going to be visiting the BMW Performance Center for the 100th time or something. But what is special about this training? I'm always very excited about training. That's one thing. But what is really special is that BMW has a school that is called the Authority School. So basically what they do is they teach all these maneuvers on paved roads that they teach to the law enforcement officers, like state troopers and all of that. And it's really tight and goes through the cones. It's just beautiful. It's like the most amazing thing ever. all right, when it comes to training. Now, what I've always wanted to do is I wanted to do the on-road training, the authority school training, because it teaches you how much you can lean the bike and where to put the weight and all of that. And then right after that, go and do the off-road training that they offer, all right, and transfer all of that knowledge from the authority school to the off-road training, because that's I think that would be a perfect combo. Unfortunately, because it's a shared location with the driving school, they never had the option to do an off-road training right after the authority school until recently, where we were actually able to get a closed group that will do the off-road training one day after the authority school. So I'm really excited because I'm going to do the two-day authority school. I'm going to have one day free, and then I'm going to do the off-road training as a combo. And it's just, I'm really looking forward for that.
Oh, that sounds very, very cool. That the authority one, I've seen videos of police on cruisers, like take these really, really tight things. That's the kind of training?
Yeah, that's the training. Yeah, that is the training. So most of the BMW Performance Center trainers, they are law enforcement officers, and they have been through that training as well. They have the resources, so they're actually able to transfer most of these drills into an actual class for everybody who wants to go there. And it's a phenomenal training, and it sounds really expert, but it's not. Every time that I've done that training, I'm the only one who has some kind of experience for that type of drills. And everybody's just a beginner when they go in, and they are changed riders when they leave at the end of the second day.
Wow, very, very cool. Now, one question: you are traveling during a pandemic. Do you have any different preparations, any plan Bs, should something occur on the road?
I'm very thankful about my job. I have the ability to take the required tests on a weekly basis. So I'm always very careful with that. I always know how, if I'm sick or if I'm not. I will be taking that test every week during my trip. So this is one of the precautions that I'm taking. So if I do find myself that I'm in trouble, the trip will end no matter what, because I have to protect the rest. I have all the personal protection equipment with me, masks sanitizer and everything that is required. And I'm always going to be very careful with the people that I'm meeting and the places that I'm going. I'm taking this very seriously because I just don't want to get anybody, in trouble if I am sick.
Yeah. Either you get sick yourself or you get others sick. Yeah. It's something it's good to hear that you've thought that through. So how can people follow your trip while you're on the road?
I'm going to be going very slow. So basically they can just ride right behind me. mostly through social media, and specifically from my Instagram account, which is my first name and then my last name in one word. So that's on Instagram. That's probably the best way of doing that.
Okay, great. Now, you're also going to be writing a series of stories that will appear in upcoming issues of On the Level. So we look forward to reading those stories. And you're a photographer, and your pictures of the GS trophy were fantastic. So I have no doubt we're going to have some great, great things in upcoming issues of On the Level. And also, we look forward to the GS Giants joining us in May in Waynesville, North Carolina for the rally. You guys have been with us for a couple of years now, and it's always fun to see you guys and set up the track and have people practice their off-road skills on the track, either by themselves or with one of the training organizations that usually come to the rally. So we hope to see you there. We're looking forward to that. And you're leaving Saturday, right?
I'm leaving this Saturday, yeah.
Wow. So best of luck to you, sir. And
thank you so much.
We'll see you on the road.
Thank you, John, and thank you for having me.